Hi, in this video we will learn how to remove a third-party MacroScript from 3D Studio Max. Let's say I want to remove this script. It's called remove from isolate. All I have to do, close 3D Studio Max and then go to this folder. It's called user macros, and you can find this folder by following this path. C, users, your username, app data, local, Autodesk, 3D Studio Max, then your Max version, in my case it's 2018 64-bit, then ENU folder, then user macros. Look for the script here. In my case, I want to remove this script, remove from isolate. I can right click, choose delete, yes, and that's it. For the app data, it's a hidden folder, so you need to enable show hidden files and folders. You can do that by going to Control Panel, File Explorer Options, then View, then click here, Show Hidden Files, Folders, and Drives. Click Apply, OK, and now you can see the app data and other hidden folders. Now, at this point, you can skip the rest of the video. Or you can continue, because we will learn how to delete the user interface elements. In my case, I want to delete the toolbar of this MacroScript because I don't need it anymore. Or maybe if you created a quad menu for your script, also we will see how we can delete that. And we will deal with the issue that sometimes you restart 3D Studio Max after deleting the toolbar or the quad menu, and then you discover they are still there. So we will learn a way to deal with that. So let's do that. First, I will restart Max. You see that the toolbar is still here. I need to go to Customize User Interface, Toolbars. Here I need to look for this toolbar. It's here, Remove from Isolate, then click Delete. Watch what will happen here. I will click Delete and now it's gone. Or if you created a quad menu, let's say for your script, you can go to quads, look for the script here, click on it, right click, and choose delete menu item. Now, sometimes when you restart Max, you discover that the toolbar is here again, and maybe the quad menu also. So to deal with that, go to here, Workspaces, Manage Workspaces. You can click this button, Save Default State. Now, in your case, you probably have this as the current workspace. Now, if you click this one, you will overwrite this default or any other workspace you have. You will be overwriting with your new layout, with your new user interface organization. So if you don't want to do that, and this is what I did, is that I created a new workspace, a custom workspace for myself. I clicked here, Save as new workspace. I give it a name, then click OK, and then close. And that's it. Now, when you restart Max, you should not see this toolbar or the quad menu appear again. By the way, if you're wondering this first name before the name of the script, the first name is the category. It's the one that you see here when you go to customize user interface. For example, in my case, my scripts, they are in the category Miri Tools. Here you can see the scripts I created. So the first part of the name is the category. Then the second part is the name of the script. If you open a script with your with a notepad, you can see here this part after the word MacroScript is the one that you see here. And basically that's it. Hope you liked the video. And if you like the video, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.